that a crappie? I can't tell. Oh, it is too.
Look at this one.
Oh my goodness me.
Fishing. It's almost that time in the North Lakes, Northern Ontario, Quebec, Manitoba, all through the northern states and stuff too, that ice is coming off and it's time to think about what kind of jigs am I going to use this year? Am I going to buy the cheap stuff and potentially lose big crappie? Or am I going to step up my game a little bit and buy a little bit nicer quality jigs with sharp jig heads so I can catch those big black and white crappies? This segment is about why I don't buy cheap jigs and plastics for crappie. It's so important. I know this topic is so delicate too, because everybody uses jigs for crappie. You know, if you're not putting a minnow on a little Aberdeen hook, a little fine wire hook, spider rigging, jigging under a float, there's a good chance you're using something like this, a little round ball head jig with a small piece of plastic to entice crappie to bite your baits. And yes, right off the top, I'll tell you, we all know that you can buy them in all the big box stores, the ones that are imported from all the way all across the world that come in, okay? But they're inferior. They still catch crappie. Crappie are not the smartest things in the world. Don't give them credit, because they just want to eat. You put your bait near a crappie, good chance if it's the right kind of color that they see, most times they bite everything from A to Z. But this segment is about considering when you're fishing for bigger crappie, the big ones, you know, the ones that are like 1.5 pounds, 2, maybe even 3 pounds plus. Those are the ones that could break your heart with subpar gear. So on this first part, I'm going to show you an example of fishing with my buddy Josh McKay in early spring. The fish were nowhere near the bank yet, but they were always positioned in that deep basin, the same places they were when there was 3 feet of ice above their head. So we're going to show you how we use the little crappie magnets, okay, and how we rig it on small little jig heads like these right here. I'm going to show you them, okay? And we got two different sizes, different colors, but something about that one particular day, this little one I call Kelly Green with the small jig heads. I'll explain it in a video that you'll see coming up, but these little baits caught some big crappie, and you know why? Because we thought about the right jig head, the right sharpness, the right gauge to make sure those bigger crappie got in the boat. All right, what sizes? You know, the wind's not really blowing very hard yet, but it's supposed to. So we've got a couple options with the crappie spinning rods, okay? So the 6-footers, we got the BM Pro 100s as well, and that's got 6-pound monofilament. And on the one rod rigged up, 1/8 ounce, smaller profile, slab bite. And when the wind picks up a little bit, it gets breezy, we want to fish directly right below the boat like you're fishing for walleye, the 5/32nds. 1-2 combo, be prepared, we're going to catch more crappie. Okay, color options. Josh said he loves the green, but with crappie magnet, they make so many options, okay? So the Kelly green, I call it, with the chartreuse, you can't beat it. And see the common theme? Green, 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 green. This one has almost like a green with a refrigerator white. Solid chartreuse, black chartreuse with a little bit of silver flake, and the therapist. These colors right here, we're not going to divulge too much from variety. And whatever seems to be catching fish, and so far Josh has proven that the bright Kelly green with the chartreuse is kicking butt of all the other colors. But have variety, be prepared, because you never know what the crappie want on the lakes you fish. It bounces it, there's so much disturbance there.
Whoa. There's one.
Good one?
Yeah.
Oh, Josh. Netter, huh?
Not a bad one.
Oh, oh. King Kong. Wow, dude. first boxer. Oh my goodness, dude. Yeah, that's nice. Josh.
Where's that crappie mane? Wow. It's gone.
Wow. Give him a close up of that. Let him zoom in on it, Josh. Wow, dude. That's a big crappie.
A nice, gorgeous fish here.
Yeah, man. You like the double green too, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Most matches your logo.
There we go. Beautiful.
Okay, man. Here's the magic. 1/8 ounce Northern Tackle Supply. And again, he's got the Mustad hooks. Excellent one of the ones. And I got white as well with the Mustad sickle. So that's the packaging, Mustads. And there's no give. Remember, we're catching King Kong size crappie. If you skimp on the hooks and stuff, little fine wire, you could be really disappointed. Men are heartbroken because these fish are big. And again, what are we doing? The smelly stuff. Smelly stuff with the right jigs. And now we're catching more crappie with the slip float. Okay, now what kind of plastics are the good plastics? There's so many on every store that carries Panfish products, carries different types of crappie jigs. Saw plastics. And again, if you're not using the meat, you probably got saw plastics all, you know, in your buckets, in your tackle bags, all through your boat and stuff like that. But this next part I'm going to talk about is soft, real soft plastics as compared to ones that are durable, the ones that catch more than one fish. Now see these little ones here? Cool looking little baits, eh? Like, not bad, right? But what happens, you get a decent crappie, it's busted. When it breaks, you got to put another one on, okay? So is it good? Good little baits, all plastic and stuff? But look how fast it just tears apart. No thanks. Little like shad baits, okay? Yeah, man, crappie's gonna eat it. But one fish or bluegills, bing, you see what happens? Now that thing is gonna catch nothing. So are you fishing or are you just pretending? Are you out there? Look at, like nothing, rips, breaks. The one thing about crappie magnet is durable, okay? Durable. More than one crappie with one bait. And here's something that maybe is important to you, because it is important to me too, okay? All crappie magnet soft baits, okay, are made in the USA. Every single one is made in the USA, okay? Patriotic, that's what I am. Maybe you want to consider about it too. It's totally up to you, because it's your money you're spending. But when you think about crappie magnet, okay, a little bit more quality plastic, okay, and some of the brightest colors in all of the industry. Like, I mean, they are totally phenomenal. They're some of the brightest colors, and we know that crappie love color. But when you think about all this soft plastic, but just a little bit more durable, crappie eat it. They're still gonna just inhale it. But is it important to you to catch more than one fish on a bait? Like, I know some guys in crappie magnet have caught some on fin spins with plastic and stuff, and they've talked about catching more than 100 crappie with one single bait. And one other thing to consider, crappie magnet baits, the crappie magnet, slab magnet, fin spin, the whole line, hair jigs, you name it, they've got the best prices in the industry. Sometimes even half the price of the competitors, a far better quality product. If that's important to you, think about crappie magnet. This next segment I'm gonna show you has me fishing, well, with this bait right here. I gotta show it to you because you've seen it, you've heard about it, that's it right there. You know what that is, right? Slab magnet. And a couple examples, it works everywhere. This one's on the Therapist, and I got it on that Northern Tackle Supply jig head. We're gonna talk about that soon. Custom color match, purple metallic flake with chartreuse, matches the Therapist. And these next examples, it's vertical jigging, so you need a durable bait and deep brush piles, and just, it catches crappie anywhere you fish. That feels, oh boy, look at that thing. Hey? Oh, wow. Yeah, man. Oh, Jared, I can't even say thank you enough. What a day, my friend. What a day. Look how deep that is, buddy.
Oh, yeah.
Did he want that one? I got to show that to the screen. Huh? Yeah. Yes, sir. Look at this. Look how deep he's got it right there. Oh, you got to see this. Look at him. Huh? Did he want that?
That is like way, way, way down inside.
Skitty?
Yeah. Crappie, your side.
Another white crappie. Deal. Right where we thought he was going to be, isn't it? Isn't that awesome?
Jeff said, that's where he's going to be. How many times I put in there? Two, three, till I got it in the right spot,
right? Up to the tree.
And then when it wasn't by the tree, he wouldn't chase it out. But when I got up by the tree and I swam it a bit, thunk. The traditional, good old thump. No bragging-sized fish, but beautiful crappie. Jeff, how many people you know in the United States would keep crappie like those?
Oh, my goodness.
Well, 60 million?
Yeah, that's exactly right. Exactly right.
So that's where we're going to put them in the box. Those are eaten-sized crappie, boy. Right there. Eaten-sized crappie.
Now, you know there's a fallacy out there about catching crappie with small baits. You know, you got to tone down. Nothing could be further from the truth. Sometimes, yes, when the water's really cold, the fish are very inactive, cold fronts, you name it. You know, all the excuses under the rainbow. But come on, really? Are you out there to catch a limit of smaller fish? That's totally up to you. But when you want to fish for bigger crappie, you know what I pick up? Crappie magnet makes this right here, and it's called the slab magnet. Bigger profile shad bait, do you see that? Bigger profile, thick, small little tail, shakes in the wind. There's some examples here of underwater footage of how easy that little tail moves. And again, I just pair it up with a Northern Tackle Supply, little jig head, matches it to a T. Purple metallic chartreuse with the bright purple and chartreuse. When crappie see this, when I'm single poling or under a float, they eat it. It's as simple as that. Another color I like is called the mermaid, okay? Green with some blue. There's all different variations across the industry of different baits. But again, durable, beautiful plastic. I can catch more than one fish with it, but it's just so soft. And that profile looks exactly, man, like the bait fish those crappie are eating, either on brush lines, deep weed, you name it. The slab magnet, you got to put some in your boat because these babies catch the big crappie.
Oh my goodness. Look at Hoss. Hoss, come here. Oh my goodness, hey? Hoss and the boss. Now I'm getting all cocky, eh? Look at that. Look at that. Seriously? Look where he's got it. Come on, man. Look at that. Seriously. There's no way you miss those. But man, you gotta pay attention. Pay attention to what you're doing, man. Watch it, just like your largemouth fishing. Another beautiful fish, man. Seriously? Let's see. Oh no, you're all skinny and stuff, man. You ain't doing business.
Is that a crappie? I can't tell. Oh, it is too.
Look at this one. Oh my goodness me. Look at those that are sitting in the nasty, huh? Tell me that's not a beautiful crappie. Look at this up close. I'm gonna show you how the mermaid works right there. Look at that. Look at that. That's like 15 inch crappies, boys. Those are big crappies. Those are big. Now you know we're really hunting them down, right? Wow, in the meat, man. In the meat. Turn. Pop out. Look at that, man. That's a big slab, boy. You know where he's going, in the good side, and then I let him go. Look at that mouth. When they inhale like that, it's gonzo.
Okay, what kind of jigs are the good jigs? Seriously, this is the money end of catching crappies. You can use any plastics you want. I explained why I use crappie magnet, because durable, cost efficiency, made in the USA, but this is the money end right here. A little piece of lead, and the ones I use, easily the best crappie jigs I've ever used in my entire life. From 1/32nd to 1/4 ounce by Northern Tackle Supply. You can get them in Mustads, Gamagatsu, Owner, the traditional Ben, or you can see that one has have the sickle hook as well too, just deadly, deadly sharp. And the things with these is you can sharpen them, okay? If you're catching a bunch of fish, and sometimes maybe the point or the edge is just not exactly where you like it, I call it dropping it on granite. If it sticks in granite and it gets sticky on your finger, it's gonna catch a crappie. But the, let's say, the cheaper ones, lower grade from overseas, once they get a little burr on them, just cut them off. So again, now you're wasting money because you're using more jigs. Well, what if you don't check your jig all the time and you're losing fish or losing that one single big fish in a tournament or just want to have fun? Losing big crappie is not fun. So think about sometimes the better jig heads, okay? Different sizes. He pours all different kinds of colors. His link to where he is on Facebook is listed below this in the video in the description. Check them out, because I'm telling you, when you want to put a piece of plastic on there and you pair it up exactly with the size of the different jig heads that you want, these will help you put those bigger crappie in the boat.
Oh, there's a good one. Yeah, that's a good one, Josh. Oh boy, big crappie.
There you go, brother.
Nice one, eh? Oh boy, Josh. This is psychotic, isn't it?
Absolutely.
The scouting.
Look at that sucker.
That's where he got it, too. Oh, man. Hold on, buddy. Look at him. I thought I was seeing things, Josh.
No sirree.
Yeah, man. Down like the crap you love to go down, eh?
Look at that slabber of a dude.
Yeah. Yikes. My fingers are frozen because it's so cold out. Look at him. Let me just get him out and I'll show you real quick. Double green. We're drifting down. We're not going to spook him, but Josh has been letting him beaten on the deep basin and the float. It's a grind out here, man. Like, it is a grind. We're catching some King Kong crappie. Put him in there, take some pictures. Look how skinny that one is. Gotta be a male, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Going?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Oh, yes, Josh. Yes, sir. What do you got going here, dude?
That's
oh, my God. That's what they are, aren't they?
Crap stars. Boom.
Big two. Beautiful fish.
Big old egg wagon here, folks. Look at that sucker.
Look at that, yeah. Pictures and.
Wow.
Beautiful fish, buddy. Beautiful fish. You are on it like.
So, what I did there, Carl, was you know those fish that we saw streaking?
Yeah.
I threw behind the boat. I brought my float up a bit and just kept popping it real slow behind the motor just a bit and then bang.
Gotcha. Okay. What kind of jigs are the good jigs? Seriously, this is the money end of catching crappies. You can use any plastics you want. I explained why I use crappie magnet, because durable, cost efficiency, made in the USA, but this is the money end right here. That little piece of lead, and the ones I use, easily, the best crappie jigs I've ever used in my entire life. From 1/32 to 1/4 ounce by Northern Tackle Supply. You can get them in Mustads, Gamagatsu, Owner, the traditional bend, or you can see that one has the sickle hook as well too, just deadly, deadly sharp. And the things with these is you can sharpen them, okay? If you're catching a bunch of fish and sometimes maybe the point or the edge is just not exactly where you like it, I call it dropping it on granite. If it sticks in granite and it gets sticky on your finger, it's gonna catch a crappie. But the, let's say the cheaper ones, lower grade from overseas, once they get a little burr on them, just cut them off. So again, now you're wasting money because you're using more jigs. Well, what if you don't check your jig all the time and you're losing fish or losing that one single big fish in a tournament or just want to have fun? Losing big crappie is not fun. So think about sometimes the better jig heads, okay? Different sizes. He pours all different kinds of colors. His link to where he is on Facebook is listed below this in the video in the description. Check him out, because I'm telling you, when you want to put a piece of plastic on there and you pair it up exactly with the size of the different jig heads that you want, these will help you put those bigger crappie in the boat.
There we go, Josh, a good one too. Oh yeah, big crappie. All right. Oh my
goodness.
Look
at that egg wagon, man. Hey. Oh, look at the belly. Look at that belly. Look at that belly. Look at that thing.
Like smallmouth, eh?
Dude, that's the tennis ball. Tennis ball.
Tennis ball, he says. Going, going. That one's looking 7. Wow. Take a look at the depth real quick, Josh.
6, 7 feet for sure.
Okay. Look, this is how Josh got him before too, right in the front of the nose. Different kind of bite. Just, it popped once, it just went down. Like there was no ifs or buts, Josh. Like
bang,
this.
Grabbed it. Beautiful.
Those are King Kong crappies, boy. Again, we'll release some. And you know I don't just use soft plastics for crappie. A little hair jigs catches so many slabs under any condition I fish, whether I'm single poling, shallow water, fishing brush lines with floats, or just fishing shallow early spring crappie or fall crappie. It doesn't matter. Something about that little profile, and you know my favorite, it's the crappie magnet Popeye jig. That little Popeye jig is, they're double glued to make sure they don't fall apart. And there's nothing worse, man, nothing worse than when you're catching crappie with a hair jig, and then all of a sudden you realize there's only a couple strands left. So now you gotta pick up another rod, tighten another bait, and again, you're spending money. You're spending money when you don't have to. So when you look in the stores, you think, man, I can buy this overseas brand for, 30 cents, 40 cents less, but potentially you'll lose more. The wrap is not, doesn't have the quality control of Crappie Magnet. Crappie Magnet makes sure that all of their baits are made for you, the consumer. They are crappie fishermen, die-hard crappie fishermen. They want to make sure that they make baits that you can use, that you can catch crappies. So a little bait like the Popeye jig and all the colors they have are fantastic, whether under a float, single poling, or the fish decide that, you know what, today I'm not going to eat plastics today. Hopefully he's got something else in his boat, because today I'm going to try a hair jig. And the Popeye jig, trust me, man, this thing has never, never let me down. Okay, here's the thing. When you're using the tiny little jig, look how small that is, man. Like, that is tiny. With the big spotted eye, a little bit of strands, okay? That's 1/16 ounce. You got to have a slip float that will sit vertically as well to signal those real light bites. So I put the split shot there to achieve that. But you don't want to use a really big round slip float like this. You don't achieve anything that way. Sure, you'll see bites on the real aggressive ones, and yeah, it'll lay down too, but it'll be more effort. When you use a little streamlined float, like the guy used for steelhead and trout, when they use single legs or little row bags and stuff, or even like little hair jigs and things, you know what I mean? Nymph, etc. This right here is the deal. You weight it, so just the last half inch is in the water. I got a bobber stop that I can move back and forth, but again, we're only fishing in about 2 feet of water, maybe. Those fish are getting ready to pre-spawn. So we just gauge it back and forth with a little jig, and we're catching them.
There you go.
I really think those painted eyes are that provoking thing when they come over and look at it. Look at my bait.
Yep, there you go. Nice.
You see that going?
Yeah.
My float was moving. Isn't it amazing how they take it?
Yeah.
And it'll just... little Popeye. We're getting the babies. Oh boy, he did take it good.
You wanted that one, eh?
Yeah, man. Wow. But that little fine wire hook, man. Hooking percentage is incredible. Oh, you might be.
Pliers are right down there. There we go. Another one. Nice. This is what we wanted to see, eh? Oh, dark one. It's dark.
Really?
Right here. Yeah.
There we go, look at that, eh? The colors.
Oh, there we go.
Wow, he's ready to do his business, huh?
Yeah.
I still put that little slab bite on. Inspire it.
Oh, yeah, for sure. But look how dark that is. Yeah. They're getting there.
Yeah.
Just full of energy, too.
Right on.
Okay, boys, keep going, mates. Keep going and keep catching. Staying back. But it's the whole chain of command, right? Little jig like that. And staying back off them.
They have no idea we're here, Joe.
Nope, none whatsoever.
They just see that little bait, and then another one comes over and decides to eat it. We need a couple of those 14s to do that.
And they're in here. We've seen them. There you go.
Oh, wow. Look at this fight. Look at them go.
Wow.
Fish on. Remember in the rivers years ago? You have to get all your lines out. That might be an eater, huh? What do you think?
Yeah, that's not bad. Hey, that's a perfect size you want to keep, right?
Yes.
Not one of the big spawners. And
skinny belly.
Yep.
That's what we want, huh? Because we want a fish fry, don't we?
We do.
Okay.
That's the best part about this time of year, I guess, right?
Yeah. Let's put them in the box. Yeah, that's perfect size. You know that? Right there. I'm going to keep that open, Joe, right there.
Alrighty.
Got another side there. Look. Work on catching some crappies. Another one?
Yep, another one lost it there. A bite is so sensitive, eh? Like you're saying, these light floats make all the difference.
Mm-hmm. And I don't think they feel anything with these light floats like this streamline.
No.
When they do take it too, it's just like they grab the little bait fish.
Yep.
Wow.
Nice.
Wow. Look at him fight, man. You gotta admit, it is so much fun.
It is.
I think I got another,
there you go.
Eater. Whoa, dark one, too.
Yeah, look at that.
That's gotta be a male, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. That little Popeye jig, just stick it in there. Wow. Yeah, look at.
Just in here cruising, they eating.
Yeah. Look, right in the meat. There's no way this fish was ever coming off, ever.
No.
Right through the meat. Wow. Nice fine wire hook. All right, Crappie, we're going to have some fun tonight. Okay, here it is. I call that the gray ghost. It's like a little bit of gray with pearl, with a bright pink eye. That's a new color. They got it in all different sizes, okay, with the number 8 hook. And this one is with the red eye, red little feather or hair with white. Fantastic. That one's the 1/16 ounce with number 4 hook. And then this one as well, big red eye, blue and white. 1/32 ounce, number 6 hook. So, Leyland Lures, Crappie Magnet, it's variety. Number 8 hook, number 6 hook, number 4 hook, in 3 or 4 different sizes of weights of jig head. They got maybe now 6 different colors. Pick your favorites, because it'll do the same things it's doing for me and Joe out here in the shallow water crappie.
Oh!
So do I.
Wrap me up in the lily pads there.
Whoa. Another one here, Joe.
You got another one anyways, eh?
Big fatty.
There you go.
Oh, that's a
nice
one.
Male.
Yep. Man. We have moved in back here.
Yep.
Oh, boy. Dude, you can hardly see the jig head even in this one.
Really, eh?
Yeah, look. Look how far down that is.
No way. Oh, this one feels like a decent one. Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy. Yes, sir. Yes, catching
and cranking.
That's
what we're talking about.
Catching and cranking, boys.
Yep. And oh, that's definitely a decent one.
Oh, yeah.
Another nice big male.
Yeah, man. We're having crappie tonight, boys and girls.
Yeah.
So they're the reasons why I don't buy cheap jigs. I love catching big crappies, whether on a bigger profile slab magnet or the crappie magnet little profile. With little Popeye jigs, there's something about using the right jigs, spending a few extra dollars on the right jig. But again, Crappie Magnet, best prices in the industry. The entire crappie industry, some of the best prices compared to the competitors. Superior plastic, catch more than one fish on one bait. You know what? Sounds like a selling feature, doesn't it? But it is, because they work, they catch fish. They've been designed by real crappie fishermen who just fished their entire lives for crappie. Okay, you got a mechanic who maybe the first time is gonna work on your brakes. He does it part-time, maybe a little bit of this, a little bit of that. Or do you want that full-time mechanic that does it 6 days a week, 5 days a week, 8 hours a day? Which one would you trust to fix the brakes in your truck? Exactly. Those are the same kind of people I want pouring my jig heads, Northern Tackle Supply. They're the same people I want who are pouring my plastics, tying my hair jigs. Crappie Magnet,
Northern Tackle Supply, spend wisely, catch big, but seriously, consider when you're out there, buying in America, made by Americans, is that important to you? It's totally up to you. Hope you subscribe to our channel, and next time, I'll talk about different topics that make you happy, that help you catch more and bigger crappie. Thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Please subscribe, give any comments, look below in the description, put your comments, and yours truly will answer every question that you have, or statement, inquiry, whatever it is, man. I'm here for you to help you catch more and bigger crappie. Thanks for watching.